As an important part of naval forces around the world, aircraft carriers play a critical role in military operations. These massive ships provide support to air and naval forces, ensuring national security, responding to crisis situations, and keeping the peace. In this article, we will examine some of the world's most powerful and effective aircraft carriers, looking at the characteristics, operational use, and future prospects of each. So, which country's aircraft carrier is the best? Without further ado, let's start analyzing and learning about their characteristics. Here are the 15 most impressive aircraft carriers in the world. 15th place, HTMS Chakri Naruebet. HTMS Chakri Naruebet is an amphibious assault ship and air carrier of the Royal Thai Navy. HTMS Chakri Naruebet was built at the Bazan, now Navantia, shipyard in Spain. HTMS Chakri Naruebet has a large flight deck that can carry helicopters as well as other aircraft. It is also equipped for amphibious operations. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. HTMS Chakri Naruebet is in service with the Royal Thai Navy and is used in various amphibious and airlift operations. The future role of HTMS Chakri Naruebet will depend on the needs and defense policies of the Royal Thai Navy. 14th place, Giuseppe Garibaldi. Giuseppe Garibaldi is a light aircraft carrier and amphibious assault ship of the Italian Navy. Giuseppe Garibaldi was built at the Fincantieri shipyard in Italy. Giuseppe Garibaldi has a large flight deck that can carry light aircraft as well as helicopters. It is also equipped for amphibious operations. Technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. Giuseppe Garibaldi is in service with the Italian Navy and is used in various amphibious and airlift operations. The future role of Giuseppe Garibaldi will depend on the strategic objectives and defense needs of the Italian Navy. 13th place, Juan Carlos I is an amphibious assault ship and air carrier of the Spanish Navy. Juan Carlos I was built at the Navantia shipyard in Spain. Juan Carlos I has a large flight deck that can carry helicopters as well as other aircraft. It is also equipped for amphibious operations. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. Juan Carlos I is in service with the Spanish Navy and is used in various amphibious and airlift operations. The future role of Juan Carlos will depend on the needs and strategic objectives of the Spanish Navy. In 12th place is TCG Anadolu, which has a very special distinction. TCG Anadolu is an amphibious assault ship that will join the inventory of the Turkish Navy. It is a ship designed and built with Turkey's indigenous capabilities. This ship is also the world's first unmanned aerial vehicle ship. Turkish engineers continue to work very hard on this issue, and it is expected to take this title in the near future. It is designed to meet all the needs of the Turkish armed forces, such as long-distance military combat and humanitarian aid operations. It is also the world's first drone carrier. Interestingly, 70% of the ship was built with domestic resources in a period of 7 years. Anadolu is 231 meters long and 32 meters wide and can also carry helicopters. It has a displacement of 27,079 tons and a draft of 6.9 m. TCG Anadolu was built at Sedef Shipyard under the coordination of Turkey's Presidency of Defense Industries. TCG Anadolu has a large flight deck that can carry helicopters as well as unmanned aerial vehicles. It is also designed for amphibious operations and can carry military personnel and equipment. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. TCG Anadolu is in the service of the Turkish Navy and is used in various amphibious and airlift operations. TCG Anadolu will make a significant contribution to the strengthening of the Turkish Navy and is expected to have a wider operational capacity in the future. 11th place, Cavour is an amphibious assault ship and air carrier of the Italian Navy. Cavour was built at the Fincantieri shipyard in Italy. Cavour has a large flight deck that can carry light aircraft as well as helicopters. It is also equipped for amphibious operations. Technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. Cavour is in service with the Italian Navy and is used in various amphibious and airlift operations. Cavour's future role will depend on the Italian Navy's needs and defense policies. 10th place INS. Vikramaditya INS. Vikramaditya is an aircraft carrier, the flagship of the Indian Navy. It is one of India's largest naval platforms. INS Vikramaditya was built at the Sevmash shipyard in Severodvinsk, Russia. It was originally built as a Gorshkov-class aircraft carrier for the Soviet Navy. INS Vikramaditya has a large flight deck capable of carrying MiG-29 fighter jets. It also has infrastructure for helicopters and naval vessels. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. INS Vikramaditya is actively used by the Indian Navy and is engaged in various operations to strengthen India's naval capabilities. INS Vikramaditya is expected to continue to serve as an important part of the Indian Navy and is expected to be modernized and strengthened in the future. Ninth place, Charles de Gaulle. Charles de Gaulle is an aircraft carrier, the flagship of the French Navy. It is an important part of France's strategic naval power. Charles de Gaulle was built in France at the DCNS, now Naval Group Shipyard. Features: the Charles de Gaulle has a large flight deck that can carry Rafale fighter jets. It also has infrastructure for helicopters and other naval vessels. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. Charles de Gaulle is actively used by the French Navy and takes part in various operations to strengthen France's naval capabilities. It is expected that Charles de Gaulle will continue to strengthen the strategic capabilities of the French Navy and will be modernized and strengthened in the future. Eighth place, INS Vikrant INS. Vikrant is India's first indigenous aircraft carrier. It is a strategic naval platform built for the Indian Navy. Development and production: INS Vikrant is being built by Cochin Shipyard Limited in India. INS Vikrant will have a large flight deck capable of carrying MiG-29 fighter jets. It will also have infrastructure for helicopters and naval vessels. Technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed have not yet been fully disclosed. INS Vikrant is under construction, and once completed, it will enter the service of the Indian Navy and take part in various naval operations. INS Vikrant is expected to increase the naval power of the Indian Navy and strengthen India's naval capabilities. Seventh place, Admiral Kuznetsov. Admiral Kuznetsov is an aircraft carrier, the flagship of Russia. It is one of the largest ships of the Russian Navy. Admiral Kuznetsov was built during the Soviet Union and later taken over by Russia. Admiral Kuznetsov has a large flight deck that can carry fighter aircraft such as the Su-33 and MiG-29K. It also has infrastructure for helicopters and other naval vessels. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. Admiral Kuznetsov is used by the Russian Navy and is involved in various naval operations. The future of Admiral Kuznetsov will depend on the Russian Navy's modernization plans and strategic goals. Sixth place, Shandong is an aircraft carrier, the second flagship of the Navy of the People's Republic of China. It was built at the Dalian Shipyard in Shandong, China. The Shandong has a large flight deck that can carry J-15 fighter jets. It also has infrastructure for helicopters and other naval vessels. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. Shandong is actively used by the People's Republic of China Navy and is involved in various naval operations. The future of Shandong will depend on the strategic plans and modernization targets of the People's Republic of China Navy. Fifth place, Liaoning. The Liaoning is an aircraft carrier, the first flagship of the Navy of the People's Republic of China. It was originally a modernization of the Varyag, a Soviet Kuznetsov-class ship acquired by China. The foundation of the Liaoning was laid during the Soviet Union. The ship was later acquired by China and modernized in Dalian. The Liaoning has a large flight deck that can carry J-15 fighter jets. It also has infrastructure for helicopters and other naval vessels. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. The Liaoning is actively used by the People's Republic of China Navy to increase China's presence at sea and support its strategic objectives. The future of Liaoning will depend on the strategic plans and modernization targets of the People's Republic of China Navy. Fourth place, Fujian is a planned Type 075 class amphibious assault ship and helicopter carrier of the People's Republic of China Navy. Fujian is under construction and is planned to be built at the Hudong Zhonghua shipyard in China. Fujian will have the capacity to be used as an amphibious assault ship as well as a helicopter carrier. It is designed for various amphibious operations and sea power projection. Technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed have not yet been fully disclosed. Fujian has not yet entered service and is under construction. With the commissioning of Fujian, the amphibious capabilities and sea power projection capacity of the People's Republic of China Navy will increase. Third place, Queen Elizabeth Class. The Queen Elizabeth Class is the newest aircraft carrier class of the Royal Navy of the United Kingdom. It consists of two ships, HMS Queen Elizabeth R08, and HMS Prince of Wales R09. The Queen Elizabeth class was built by Babcock International and BAE Systems. The Queen Elizabeth class has a large flight deck capable of carrying F-35B Lightning II Stovall fighter jets. It also has infrastructure for helicopters and other naval vessels. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. Queen Elizabeth class ships serve as the flagships of the Royal Navy of the United Kingdom. They are used for various naval operations and to provide support to NATO allies. The Queen Elizabeth class will continue to be an important asset that will strengthen the UK's national defense capacity by increasing the UK's naval power. Second place, Nimitz class. The Nimitz class is the largest class of aircraft carriers in the United States Navy. It includes a total of 10 ships. The Nimitz class ships were built by Newport News Shipbuilding. Nimitz class ships have a large flight deck that can carry a wide variety of fighter aircraft, such as the FA-18 Hornet and FA-18 Super Hornet. They also have infrastructure for helicopters and other naval vessels. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. The Nimitz class ships are an important part of the United States naval power and are involved in various naval operations and international crisis interventions. Although some of the Nimitz-class ships have been withdrawn from service, the next Ford-class ships, traditionally known as large-scale aircraft carriers, are expected to enter service. First place, USS Gerald R. Ford class. USS Gerald R. Ford is the United States Navy's newest and most advanced aircraft carrier class. USS Gerald R. Ford is the first ship of this class. Gerald R. Ford-class ships are built by Newport News Shipbuilding. The USS Gerald R. Ford has a large flight deck capable of carrying a wide range of combat aircraft, such as the FA-18 Super Hornet and the F-35C Lightning II. It also has infrastructure for helicopters and other naval vessels. It has technical specifications such as displacement, length, width, and speed. USS Gerald R. Ford serves as one of the most important parts of the United States naval power. She is actively involved in various naval operations and international crisis interventions. The USS Gerald R. Ford class will enhance the United States naval capabilities and continue to play a strategic role for years to come. I hope you enjoyed it. Write in the comments which is the best aircraft carrier in your opinion. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to the channel. You will be notified about my new videos by activating the bell button. See you in the next video.